If I were a painter, I would paint my reverie. If that's the only way for you to be with me, we'd be there together, just like we used to be. Underneath the swirling skies for all to see.
Hi, I'm Crystal, and welcome to the Breakers of Long Beach. Auril Thompson stays here.
Introducing my aunt, Auril Thompson. She is now 93 years old, born in 1917, and has done all of the beautiful artwork that you're about to see. I am her sister Bernice's eldest child, her daughter, Karen Ann Bennett.
In the animation industry, all of my working years. And I worked for how many years? I started in 1939, and I quit about 90.
So over 50 years.
Way over 50 years.
My aunt was in the animation industry. And tell a little bit about the things you worked on.
I had my own ink and paint department, and as well, I worked at Disney's. That was the first place I put my application in, but the one came from Warner Brothers first, so I went to Warner Brothers. And this is something that I had drawn and finished, and it when it's on the matte paper, it will adhese to other papers. And I had a series of pictures that were Xerox. And so this picture inadvertently adhesed to the back of it. It just stuck to the back, and you couldn't see that there was a second picture. And so the one that was on top, I wanted to discard. So what I did is rip it in four pieces. I ripped it from here to here, and from here to here.
Accidentally.
Oh. And here was this thing that I loved, and it was gone because I didn't check it. So what I did was pray, and then put on a flat surface, put these two bottom pieces together, shoved them together as much as I could mesh the layers of the paper, and then just tape it at the bottom and tape it a little at the top. And then I had to do the same thing with the top and just pray that it wouldn't leave a line. And so then the worst part was putting her whole face together, because it went, well, you can see it right here. It goes through the face if you look carefully. But then when I had it all put together, I took it to the Xerox place, had them Xerox it, and it came out looking like this. So that you have to know that those things are there, or you can't see them. And I don't know how they ever meshed back to that position. But anyway, this is one of my favorites. I was working for Chuck Jones under MGM, and we were doing a series of the Dr. Seuss stories. One of the stories was How the Grinch Stole Christmas, and so Chuck wanted me to make an 8-foot character. Do you mind if I sit down?
No.
Please.
I'm gonna wobble.
Please.
He wanted me to make an 8-foot character of the Grinch. Well, an 8-foot character is awfully big, and to try to do it paper mache is out of your mind. To ride in the Christmas parade in 1966. Down Hollywood Boulevard. And so I did. I made it at the studio while we were making the other things, and it was so tall that I had to lay it down on the floor because it can't go out an ordinary door like that. No way could you get it out of this room. And so anyway, fortunately we had a double door delivery thing at the back of the my studio, and so we could open that and get it out and get it into the car. But it was something, and I have a picture of me molding his face, because I did the face. As you can see, it takes a little more detail. And yeah. I did the face with paper mache mulch and sat on a ladder and figured in his face. These are all just, these are not taken from anything.
It was just your
imagination. And this is one version of what my one of my drivers looked like.
Okay.
And this I love. This was one of the first ones that I did. And this is a little Irish girl with flowers.
Oh wow.
Tears in
her
eyes.
The mixture of the colors are amazing.
I know, isn't it? It's just astonishing.
What year you did this one?
What year did you do that?
This year.
This year?
A couple of months ago, when I was feeling better. Not this year. Excuse me. This
92.
This last year.
Yes.
In
when you were
09.
Yeah. 09, when you were 92 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Good. And then this is like an Aztec or someone from Mazatlan. And it's just it just started out as a picture, and then it just evolved with the headdress and then the lace around it and so on. And she just looked like that.
Yeah.
It's just something that there's no picture, there's no nothing, because you can't do that and put your feelings into it. And this is so anyway, that's what I've been up to. She looks like someone in a cathedral. Something. And she's not finished yet because her face isn't. But the background looks like it's in a cathedral.
Yeah.
And it's just because of the way the paint moves when you're working with it. And here's one that isn't finished. Two men.
What year you paint this one? Last year?
All in the last 6 months, 7 months. Something like that. And then I started not feeling as well as I could, and haven't gotten back to it, but I've got to, because there's much to finish.